trees that seem towering away from all the happenings, abandoned work weeks for traveling, and much like the thick mountain mist, memories are obscured, and I'm learning how much I can forget of the people I used to be, and vacations we would take to escape the summer heat. But to my parents, these are family highlights, and to me, they only seem like distant past lives. With a calming white noise as my brother and I battle with wooden swords, with the altitude air thinner than my asthma could afford, and the smallest smell still triggering. In the spring, the pines connect me to that distant ancestor who explored nearby caves and climbed up mountains of sand, and that soft kid would sleep in heated blankets in bed. But family photos can't capture who we were in one shot. I need a place to preserve my past lives, who they were and were not, and stop all this obstruction by my newest thoughts, so I'll detail each memory until nothing's forgot. Like when a moped came in a red wrap bow on my brother's birthday, and I nagged him all day to ride it until he finally caved. And on my first trip around the block, I was run down by an elderly woman in total, the only present that he had got. She hardly stepped out to see I was alive and just drove off. For when the metal goalpost fell on my 9-year-old head and I was bleeding so bad, my dad on the phone with 911 drove me to the hospital, and I got 18 staples to cover up the crack in my skull. Capture who we were in one shot. I need a place to preserve my past lives, who they were and were not, and stop all this obstruction by my newest thoughts. So I'll detail each memory until nothing's forgot. And I need to stop treating life like it lives in a frame for me to critique and rip out the borders. It's not flat, there's no set path, so stop self-imposing corners. And I used to dream of turning into some ideal person, but the years keep adding these new layers of perversion. But I still look up to stick my arms out to reach, but they're getting tired of the miles in between, with this pursuit of perfection creating a hole in myself. So why am I set on digging my own way to hell? Why am I set on digging my own way to hell? Oh, why am I set on digging my own way to hell? Why am I set on digging my own?
Before my dad, but he got into heavy drugs, and you just wanted no part in that. Then at a party met your partner for eternity, gave birth to my brother, and started this family. And you're the mom. Background as if you're every other.
guess the selfless really do hide in plain sight. Along the coastline, when someone pulled out in front of us with our car totaled, stranded on the side of the street and never getting to revisit what we drove thousands of miles to see, onto a hotel in the Las Vegas Strip, and what starts out as a nice trip had to turn into this. When I ran out of the room once, I saw the makings of a fist. And it's funny how my thoughts on a city can change in one instant. But this is where you rushed off to get married with my dad, and your parents were the only ones in the aisle who had shown up to watch. But you were so humble and didn't need to do it up. I know the two of them just there to watch you was enough. And on your birthday this year, with bloodshot eyes, you said that your dream in life was to raise kids that turned out half as messed up as you did. And the only gift you wanted was for me to say you did the best you could in a place so reminiscent of hell sometimes. But I tend to dwell in our worst of moments, but somehow you still believe everything is fine. And it's that unyielding kindness that keeps, oh, that keeps, oh, that keeps me in line.
It's well understood that you like your bottle of wine, but how much can I criticize after you just worked all day to provide? It's just you ramble nonsense on the theory of life, and I just wish you could tell me what you believe when it's not coated in the smell of wine, 'cause I avoid you at all costs in that state. Is it dampens my image of the mother who's kept my head on straight? I know it's irrational that I try to separate the times that us four interact to keep the peace and a healthy state of mind. It's not that I expect all parts to run perfectly year round. I am just running from any situation that ends in a mental understand. It isn't getting any easier with your mother passing away last year. Just feeling like your children don't need you or old, 'cause 'cause your husband is younger by 7 years, but you will keep persisting, and I truly now do miss you outside of any necessity. And don't worry of age if it's brought the thoughtfulness to forgive us for the moments that you're a household slave. Though our workaholic nature will work us into our graves, this ethic you pave certainly has its place, 'cause when I stay busy I can feel you in me, and it's just one of the ways I will keep you alive. I will keep you alive. I will keep you alive. I will keep you alive long after you return to wherever we derive. I will keep you alive. I will keep you alive. I will keep. But the places he goes all warp into horror scenes and illegal morbid dreams. Actively trying to calm himself down from the stress of his demanding worldview that's a destructive restlessness that he cannot undo. And everything is in extreme, so it's easier for his brain system of bookkeeping. And if it's not filed away somewhere, he'll get away with white lie bullshitting, scared of traffic and strangers and cold hospital air, or anything that is putting himself out. And Randy, you're becoming just who you never wanted to be, where it seems kindness becomes less important than your personal priorities. And you always had the image of the optimist you would someday be, but a constant happiness just feels inaccurate. Artist's name is said sarcastically. Creating a body of work as if somehow that could earn him worth, and jumping from self-love to loathing to praising, then scolding every move he makes, standing beside himself as some mythical version to hide how boring he is as a person, 'cause he shares his idea of a wild night out with that of the Puritans. And Randy, you're becoming just who you never wanted to be. You do not handle well humility, and you're taking yourself too seriously. And these criticisms that come from all the comparisons you make create a senseless envy the kind that is offered by the garden snake. And I know he too would eat what is forbidden in their place. Creative process he praises to raise him from the dead feelings he sometimes has, but the process is both a revival as far as he knows and what is making himself decompose, and it's this obsessive curse that creates his best days alongside his world. Randy, you're becoming just who you never wanted to be. Someone who always says no and then hermits away to the guarantees of safety just to torture himself once he's all alone over all of the things that he does not know, like an ankle bracelet that buzzes when he leaves his comfort zone. That holds him back from any meaningful experience.
Sleeping in bed when a gunshot
shot broke the window of their high-rise apartment, and she crept around until she got to his office and found him with all of the hurt that he has caused her. 'Cause there's no worse way to work through your problems than to think that removing yourself will solve them. And this is for the loss of Greg. You were only 53 and no problems that big that you couldn't have found another way out. I know you were losing your business, but you permanently damaged the person that you lived up from a painful place that people prefer best we leave untouched. But I'm just being honest with what I know, and I want my family to live on in a format that cannot decompose. Thank you.
an endless overwhelm.
in fear, that never whispered any answers that I was seeking into my ear. 'Cause I was far past the point of asking, let alone to hear. Only dragging up every deep-seated demon I'd been hiding from for years. Thank you. friends. They pull me out from viewing my life through this lens that's too clouded, cracked, and self-consumed in demystifying universal truths that only leaves me trapped in a view that insists that the only truth is the glib glance of a pessimist. But I used to feel so intrigued as a child, felt a wider range of emotions, and my brain wasn't compiled of the horror stories of history from lives that came before and the nature of my surroundings I had yet to explore. Because as I've grown, the universe sure has grown up too, expanding with my bones to the observable from the room.
It's not
some glacial pace, finding dreams much more soothing than any reality to face.
Daddy, what is this, Daddy?
up such different interests and views, but we attempt a great relationship of our own. But I ruin the balance and indulge in being alone. But I see on the horizon a day where I wish I would have walked down the stairs and poured out everything. But I'm too scared of facing where we might really be, or to find all we can relate to is archaic memories. But you're my greatest teacher, and intentions are always good. Just trapped in a situation you think compromises some manhood. But these outlashes are slowly becoming outliers, and I see you now as someone trying to put out their own house fire. 'Cause there is such a lighter side you selectively show, that's being covered up in all these ways that you have no control. But any time I see you smiling or just laughing to a joke, I want to clutch you and apologize for my years of quiet scorn. But I can name at least one more thing that will always be our crutch, and that is nothing in our life ever seems to be enough. No, nothing in our life ever seems to be enough. No, nothing in our life ever seems to be enough. No, nothing in my life ever seems to be enough. And it's really just a lack in ourselves returning back around. It's really just insecurity manifesting as a mirror. It's really just our entitlement that's weighing us down. It's really just the discontent of our ego's fear. So rip your mind out of the next few years and just place it in the moment before it disappears.
Good night, boys. Good night, boys. Don't let the bears get you.
Down.
come home, you throw the remote through the TV, but that's nothing compared to some of the things that I have seen that I will not speak about. I don't want to think about it, much less have to say it out loud. But let's just say full of broken furniture so quickly replaced and apologies that never really held any weight, as if this daily routine would never see another day, regardless of how you both blow up over the smallest things. And then we throw in some impatience, bipolar and abrasive nature caused by a flawed childhood we all had, but it's becoming a cyclical path that I run from. But as I step off, I see what is to come. Unless I express it in this healthier way, I will be damned to repeat these exact same mistakes. These mistakes from when, much like a storm of violent clouds, I would hear my home torn apart, forced to wait it out. And though it's the source of my stress, I relinquish my anger, but I will not forget. And as I am up to my neck, drowning in flash floods of flash, I know you won't believe me, but I forgive all the times family lost its meaning. I know you won't believe me, but I forgive all the times family lost its meaning.
Thank you.
not something that you're willing to stop, and your own self-destruction is coming at the cost of your son. And I know I should stop trying to fix all these holes in a raft I perceive as the Titanic, but I know you too well just to call it quits and let you live away. I know you loathe to exist, and I still cry when I close my eyes, and I can hear you screaming still. But the house is silent, I had conjured some violence while no one was home. Projected in my brain like it was the real thing, I hear your voices sometimes and I feel like I am going insane, and I fear I've developed some mental illness with this irrational way I create violence out of stillness. And petrichor, all that I smell is what's left of the storm, and I've watched my face change forms too many times to recognize it anymore. And I'm becoming too attached to a life, and I know this too shall pass, but I can't continue keeping myself from the time I won't get back. But it's not the walls that are peeling, but the family in feeling that the foundation could collapse on any given weekend that I come home to visit. I prefer you at a distance when I can still retreat back to my quiet existence, and I can't even drink without seeing your visage when my vision is blurred. All I do is mirror your image. And petrichor, all that I smell is what's left of the storm, and I've watched my face change forms too many times to recognize it anymore. And I'm becoming too attached to a life, and I know this too shall pass, but I can't continue keeping myself from the time I
behave rudely. It does not seek its own, nor is it provoked. Love thinks no evil. It doesn't rejoice at iniquity, but love always rejoices in truth. And the one thing that you both can always count on, love will never fail if truth is established in your home from the very beginning. Now, if you, Jeffrey, and you, Connie, have at present appeared for the purpose of being joined in marriage, would you signify this by turning and facing each other and holding hands? Do you, Jeffrey, take this lady, Connie, that you now hold by the hand? promise to love and cherish her, sickness and in health, in prosperity and in adversity. Connie, do you in like manner agree to receive Jeffrey as your wedded husband? Love and respect him, live with him in all faith and tenderness, in health and in sickness, in prosperity and in adversity.
My parents left to look for a nice place to rest, to put a down payment on their final real estate investment, and now their nest is emptying their downsizing. The best talks I remember came after the storm of a screaming family member. And for all the years I dreamed of moving out, finally I was packing my things. Car door to leave, my daddy runs out crying harder than I have ever seen, and not just 'cause soon I'd be gone, but for the glow of escape I'm sure he saw on my face. But I'll still come down to visit and make sure you're fine, and we'll laugh as we try to be an average family. At dinner time, but quickly, of the few things that I could never forget, you said, I promise to be a better grandfather than dad if I'm not dead by then. 'Cause after everything was broken and shattered, all that was left was laughter, because the talks I remember came after the storm of a screaming family member. Uh-huh.
all of the love they embodied throughout their lives. 'Cause after they're gone, all they become is whatever I say they were. And my brother and I prefer to toast a glass half full when we